Tribute means movies. Pick up Tribute Magazine for the brightest stars, the most up-to-date previews, and the hottest movie coverage anywhere.
Slow way down. Slow way down.
Available at both Famous Players and Cineplex Odeon theaters.
Very tight. And then when the makeup guy just doing makeup.
And be sure to check out the MuchMusic page in every issue. In this issue, Tribute fills you in on Cameron Diaz. Also find out what happened to the 80s Rat Packers, plus Psycho, Star Trek, and more. November's Tribute in theaters now.
I'm your Tamagotchi, so happy that you love me.
Sony Music presents MC Mario Dance 2001.
Can we take it to the max?
Welcome to the world of dance.
It goes a little something like this.
With Armin Van Helden, Ron DMC, and Jason Nevins.
All your favorites in one CD. MC Mario Dance 2001 in stores now.
Please welcome to the Much Environment a return visit. Marilyn Manson has been twice to the Much Environment before. He's back again. Thanks for coming. And the reason why you're here is because the show's in Toronto tomorrow.
That's right.
At Arrow Hall. So what are you going to do tonight? Do you have plans for tonight?
We're doing a record signing at HMV.
Well, that's in the early afternoon. You have a whole night off, though.
Yeah. I don't know yet. Okay. I haven't made any plans yet.
I'm sure we'll get into some fun. Anyway, this is latest album, Mechanical Animals. The ongoing chapter in the life of Marilyn Manson, obviously a new look, a new sound. Is that a conscious effort, or you just felt it was time to maybe vary things up a bit?
Well, just with my personality, I feel the need to grow. I get bored easy. I think it would have been silly to repeat what I already did. So because the last album changed me so much, or writing a book changed me, this is kind of the result of the change, you know, second part to the story.
Well, we'll talk about some of the changes a little bit later, but you've always cited Bowie, Mark Bolan as huge references, always, but why now? Why this album for an obvious nod to that sound, to that period?
Well, seven of the songs on the album are kind of an homage to what people make me out to be. Sort of an icon. The other seven songs are more internal. And because the record was about me putting myself back together again after stripping away all my emotions, I was thinking about my childhood a lot. So the music that I liked growing up was very inspirational on this record.
Okay. You've picked LA as your home now. And throughout the whole record are these little glimpses of the lifestyle, maybe the mentality involved. From a standpoint of you laughing at it, almost, but yet you choose to live there and seem comfortable there. There's a bit of a dichotomy.
That's kind of the way I've always lived, in that paradox. You know, we started the band in Florida, which is a very sunny place, very happy place, and it kind of created, you know, an angry tone for what we were doing. So to find a place like LA where I don't feel comfortable, I, in turn, feel comfortable. So it's kind of a bizarre paradox.
You seem to be reveling in it, though, like really enjoying the lifestyle, and yet laughing at it.
That's the only way you can enjoy it, you know. So many people are a part of it, or they hate it. But if you, you know, you can't write about something unless you live it. You can't stand back and say, well, this is wrong, or this is that. You have to get in it and tell people about it.
Okay. And is the acting element that goes along with being there, you're going to be in a movie soon with Rose, I was just reading.
Very small part. Just a sex scene. That's all I'm really good for.
You did that in the David Lynch film, too.
Yeah, see? Typecast.
You're being typecast, I know. I guess that's good. No, you've always wanted to, you said, change the mainstream. It was always a big goal. Do you feel you're there yet, or almost there?
I think so. It's right now, it's kind of a struggle to put rock and roll back in the mainstream, you know, in general. So I think kind of like pulling a lot of weight for other bands as well, because rap music is so strong in America. There isn't any real rock stars, and something that I've still been fighting for all these years.
Okay. Well, we're going to take a look at Dope Show, the first single from Mechanical Animals. We have something called the MTV version, where the word queer is pixelated out and the vocal is dropped out for that word. But yet there's two cops kissing. And I understand with the George Michael video, there's also two cops kissing, which they had to ban.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I find it silly because, you know, I don't think anything's hateful about saying the word queer in the context that I used it. And it's just one of those things. You know, there's always a double standard. There's always bizarre rules. And especially for me, because people are always questioning what my motives are. I'm always under the microscope. So if I say the word queer, they automatically think it should be, you know, bleeped out.
Why the trend in cops kissing, do you think? It's like two videos in the past 2 months, or 3 months, where that's happening.
Well, I think cops inherently represent gay icons. It's the nightstick.
That threatens people.
I've been to jail, and I've been touched in certain places by police officers, so I'm trying to give back to the community what they give to me.
In the process of them frisking you, I guess.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, we're gonna take a look at Dope Show, but join us because we're gonna be back and talk some more, so don't go away. That's a quiet crowd here. It's quiet.
Yeah.
dope show from Mechanical Animals, of course, Marilyn Manson, who's here in the environment, and we're just talking about a second video completed, which will be on the air real soon. I think it's a matter of weeks. For what single?
I don't like the drugs, but the drugs like me.
Okay, now, the reference to drugs comes up a lot on the record. And I'm just wondering, well, because you've admitted in doing a lot, or experimenting a lot, is there something you're trying to say with the song?
Well, the whole album, I speak about this unobtainable entity called Coma White, which at times could be looked at as a drug or a person or even the fans or even myself. And I try and point out on the album that drugs kind of go beyond the obvious and that it kind of exists in just people's need to suppress their feelings. As I started to gain back all my emotions and talk about them on the record, I began to see the rest of the world as being very mechanical. And drugs, you know, as a metaphor, are how people suppress, you know, being actually human, you know, with religion or with television or whatever you want to, you know, choose.
Any cops kissing in that video?
Probably not. No cops kissing in that video.
Prior to this album, I guess after the biography was written, you talked about for the first time in your life, or first time in years, gaining empathy for people, and I guess for situations. Saying that, I'm wondering if, in order to have empathy, you have to understand someone's mentality or where they're coming from before you can have empathy. That's what empathy is. So, having said that, has there been any regret over things you might have said or did in the past?
No. I think you learn from mistakes, learn from all your experiences. Not even just as a writer, not even as a musician or a spokesperson or whatever people want to expect me to be. This is a person who writes down their thoughts. It all comes from experience. So I think the more you live, the more you have to say. So I don't regret anything I've done.
Fair enough. The aspect, though, of making mistakes you talked about, do you care to elaborate what kind of mistakes you think you've made in the past?
Aside from a few really bad guitar players, nothing. Oh, come on.
Poor Zim fans over there, they're all upset now.
Sorry.
Okay. So that's just it?
But there was one girl that lives here in Canada who unfortunately got Zim tattooed around her stomach. I feel bad for her the most.
Is that you? That's not you, is it?
No, that's not her.
Okay.
No, it's not their fault they were bad guitar players.
Okay,
they're nice people.
What about the stance on, you know, certain people's faith? You've always
kind of adapted a new feeling towards Christianity this year, and that is to point out that although the religion I don't agree with, the idea of Jesus Christ as an icon I've started to appreciate on a different level, because to me he was the first rock star. He had his shirt off, he was wearing the loincloth. He had the 12 disciples, you know, drinking wine, he had prostitutes.
Yeah.
So I identify with him most now. I think I'm bringing back what Christ started. After all, God invented drugs, God invented rock and roll, so why can't we all enjoy him?
The way you speak about it, though, you know, to have empathy, these people have found peace, people who have faith. They have found peace. To them, it is tangible. It is a tangible thing, and they're happy.
Well, I think the happy ones we don't hear from, the ones that haven't found peace are the angry ones that are trying to stop us from having fun. So I don't think they found peace at all. I think that they're, you know, in need of something more than anyone else.
You can't argue with the solid foundation of Christianity, though, which is one of love.
No, I mean, if you read the Bible, there's a lot of good stories and there are a lot of good morals that I think exist and that everyone will agree with because they're in every culture. It's just the idea of suppressing people, making them feel guilty for being human beings. You know, the idea of sin is that you're born a sinner. You're going to be guilty for being yourself all your life, and there's nothing you can do about it. So I think that leads to unhappiness. I think we should be proud of our faults, be proud of the fact that you can get angry, you hate somebody. It's not something that you should go cry about. You know, it's being human.
Do you still look down on the... You said sort of the herd mentality, the sheep mentality that goes along with following a faith. where there is no room for individuality?
Well, Antichrist Superstar examined that on a lot of different levels. It even examined the herd mentality of rock and roll. And I think by looking at that, it made all of us smarter. It made the fans smarter, it made me smarter. I think it gave us all the perspective to realize that Christianity and rock and roll are very similar in a sense. And if you can see that, you can point out your own hypocrisy, then you can go above it. You can try and be realer than anything else.
Is that message getting out, though? Because for the most part...
Ask these people.
Yeah, well, looking around, though, they're still dressed in black.
Well, that's good now, because I'm not, so they're not imitating me. They're being themselves. They're doing what they want to do. I think everybody's just trying to, you know, it's also the idea that everyone can be a star. You know, you look around, you see these people, they're going to stand out on a street corner more than anyone else. And that's their first step at, you know, being what they want to be.
Were you at all comfortable with the goth tag?
Goth music's, you know, been something that I've liked. I don't think I ever wanted to be limited to that.
So this album almost was a...
Well, I think parts of this record are more goth than the last one, if you want to look at it from, you know, that point of view. But, I mean, labels are for journalists, you know. I think it's just rock and roll. That's what it's always been to me.
Okay. The, what you wore in Dope Show, some might say could be representative of a feminine side to you. Would you agree with that, or maybe a new discovery?
To me, it was the image on the album cover was to represent vulnerability. It was to represent an undefinable persona, to represent sexlessness and both sexes at the same time. So it did have feminine elements, but it was also sexless at the same time.
Okay. We're going to talk about the show tomorrow in Toronto again, and how many more Canadian dates? You had problems last time when you were here. Just one problem, really.
I think just one. This is the only one right now.
Okay. And how's, has it been smooth?
So far.
Okay.
Yeah.
The crowd chanting, some of the things you've been known to say in the past. I have to bring up "We hate love, we love hate" mantra, which you get the crowd to repeat. Does that still happen? Do you honestly believe that?
Well, I think a lot of people, upon first hearing that, assume that to be a message of hatred, but I think it's a paradox and it's a contradiction. I think it's a very beautiful statement, actually. It's very ironic. And
to encourage hate?
I don't think it's encouraging hate. I think if you examine it and take it apart mathematically, it's not encouraging anything. But you know, that song, Irresponsible Hate Anthem, that chant introduced, was a mockery of what people think of me and what people think of my fans.
Okay. Well, thanks for being here. Appreciate
Thank
it.
Thank you.
And we're going to end right now. We're going to go back and take a look at Beautiful People, and sometime in the next couple of weeks, we'll have a brand new video from Mechanical Animals just for you. Right now, going back a few years to Beautiful People, Marilyn Manson, I'm Much. Are you going to sign? No, I guess we got to get out of here.
ever been with more than two prostitutes?
The woman thing is not a, you know, the guy thing, I feel a little uncomfortable.
I mean, you know we're not getting together, right? You know, you do like women.
Night in Toronto. Manson performed for thousands of fans at Arrow Hall. The controversial entertainer is promoting his latest album called Mechanical Animals. Meanwhile, Manson will be greeted with prayers instead of protests in Syracuse today. Religious leaders opposed to the Marilyn Manson concert there. The concert's going to be tonight. They plan to hold a peaceful prayer gathering on the sidewalks near the concert venue. Organizers of the prayer meeting say their goal is to pray for a change of heart in the band and in their fans. Well, don't hold on to your hats, babies, because not as long as those bucks keep rolling in for old Marilyn. Two bands now. One is a veteran act. The other is a relative newcomer. Fans can catch both of them tonight at the Warehouse.
With my personality, I feel the need to grow. I get bored easy.
This week's edition of Facts. I'm Rebecca Rankin. Well, this was a huge week for shows in and around the Toronto area. Metallica were here, Big Wreck and the Watchmen were in town, and as you can see right here, the always entertaining Mr. Marilyn Manson. The day before he performed, he came into Much Music, talked to Bill Welychka, who promoted his new album, Mechanical Animals.
This is latest album, Mechanical Animals, the ongoing chapter in the life of Marilyn Manson. Obviously a new look, a new sound. Is that a conscious effort, or you just felt it was time to maybe vary things up a bit?
Well, just with my personality, I feel the need to grow. I get bored easy. I think it would have been silly to repeat what I already did. So because the last album changed me so much, or writing a book changed me, this is kind of the result of the change. Seven of the songs on the album are kind of an homage to what people make me out to be, sort of an icon. The other seven songs are more internal, and because the record was about me putting myself back together again after stripping away all my emotions, I was thinking about my childhood a lot, so the music that I liked growing up was very inspirational on this record. I'm not a child.